So why not? And it makes me happy. She seems very happy. If she were suffering at all, I would feel very differently.
Right.
And I would not put her through this.
Mm-hmm.
But she doesn't seem to have suffered much at all, except for that chloramphenicol when she had the MRSA bug.
Yeah.
Apparently, you know, humans take that drug when they get a staph infection as well.
Oh, yeah, that's a
and
very
we
toxic.
Don't put them out to pasture, so,
well,
you know,
I think that there's a quality of life decision that people make, but, you know, I certainly think it's wonderful that you feel, you know, so personally responsible for her and that you've meant so much to her. It's great. And that,
thank you. Well, I have another friend whose dog just went on it,
yes.
Went on the TA-65, and she actually feels the same way about her dog. She does not have any children, and she feels the same way. And after seeing a webinar and talking to me and somebody else, she immediately, well, I gave her one of my, and she started her right away. So I think there are other people like me out there who, if they knew there was an option between
yeah.
simply buying some time and actually continuing to have a life with that dog, they would opt for the latter. I think they will.
I think,
do.
I mean, Leona Helms, I think, left like $10 million to her dog. So, I mean, dogs they give so much and they ask for
yes.
so little. I mean, it just
yes.
can really help our psyche in so many ways. And for you to give back is just wonderful, I think. Because I think it's very rare that
you.
Somebody would spend that kind of money on an animal, but, you know, it's the same with people. Are not usually ready to go, and if you can give them a quality of life, and I think in a way, I don't know about a dog spirit or eternal soul, you know, but I think, you know, that kind of rebirth, shall we say, I mean, she
yes.
must feel great, running up the hills in the snow. I remember when you called me, that's a wonderful moment in any sentient being's life, I think.
Yes, and she's actually taken on all of her old behaviors that she had prior to the amputation. I mean, every single one.
Like
jumping up on the couch and sleeping on the couch a couple hours a night, and then jumping down. She plays tug of war, and you know, does the sort of ferocious, you know, growl thing, even though she knows she's playing. And she does that with her front paw digging into the, you know, into the carpet. And so nothing has sort of bogged her down at all. And the other day, she even went after a stick that another dog was going after in the water, and she got it first, which
fierce.
Was, she's very competitive.
I love
but,
it.
So all the old behaviors are back, which is, amazing.
That is
wonderful.
Is it okay for us to take a couple questions? Do you mind? I'm gonna
sure,
ask.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think there was a gentleman who was earlier on wanting to ask something, so I'll unmute him. Hello, are you on, Art?
Yeah, I'm on. Can I ask
oh.
a question? What dose did she use for the dog, and how, when she changed dosage, what made her do it, and how did she figure out what dose to use? And then I have another question for you, Ed, which is, what do you think of the mechanism that's doing all this? But first,
right.
I'd like to know the dosage.
Kathy, okay. You heard that?
Yes. Should I just respond?
Yeah.
Yeah. I started her on 2 per day because I think that's what you suggested right from the get-go.
Mm-hmm.
But what I did is when I read the TA Sciences website and also talked to a friend of mine who's on TA-65 but at a very high dose, 12 per day, and she has some very severe cancer conditions, I thought, just have it. Just have what my other friend is doing, which she's doing 12 a day. So I thought, let's just go to 5.
Well, you know, back in 2007, before I even took it, I looked at all the safety, toxicity studies, and I can tell you that the pharmacokinetics are such that you can give a ton of it to rats or rabbits, and there's nothing toxic about it. So it's really a budgetary thing. The more, the better. And my professional golfers who take it, I say, you know, during the stress of tournaments, double up, take eight. But again, I really don't think there's a toxic amount you can take, but there's a point at which the returns are diminishing, certainly.
I
can tell you, having been on none to four a day, there is a difference with every extra capsule. So,
well, Ed, what do you think is the mechanism that affects cancer?
Well, I don't think there is a well, it's hard for me to make any claims like that, but my intuition or my theory would be it's improving the cellular adaptive immune system, which is helping to clear the cells. But there's also an apoptosis element. So certain cancer cells that are damaged in terms of their DNA may go through a final stage of self-killing. So that's all theoretical. And again, this is very anecdotal. It's just one dog's experience, but I think...
No, but I mean, have they done any serious studies on cancer in either humans or dogs?
I don't know if I would use the word serious. It's more anecdotal. I mean, you can see just a few weeks ago we did one with Dr. Shima, and he opened up his registry to us, and out of 150 patients or so, you know, all but four are still doing quite well. You know, the number fluctuates, but you have to understand that we're talking about diseases with really bad prognosis, and including Lulu, who should be quite ill at this point. So for her to actually feel better and perform better is not typical. But it's, you know, TA-65 is working on every cell to rejuvenate it, so it's on every level.
Yeah, my question is the pluses that Lulu is seeing. Is Kathy taking the TA-65?
Should I go ahead, Ed?
Absolutely. It's a party line. Have at
right. It. Okay. Yes, I am not taking it yet, and I...
Do you have a reason why?
Well, I had a reason, and my reason was I really wanted to hear all the facts and then about whether... Because the myth in the old boy medical community, the myth is that telomerase activated will cause cancer. That's the myth. And so that's a reason one of my best friends is not taking it, and I wish she were. But then when the webinar was done on why TA-65 cannot cause cancer, I felt pretty comfortable with feeling that it will not cause cancer in me. But what's happened is, quite honestly, and Ed knows this, I have bought a lot of TA-65
for
other people. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I heard some background noise there.
Sorry. I'm developing spinal instruments. I apologize.
Okay. So Kathy was saying,
I can hear her.
That she's donated a lot of TA-65 to friends, so she's really allocating resources where she thinks, right? Or
yeah, and I felt like let's go to the neediest cases first. I have a friend in New York who has breast cancer who I've given several bottles to just get her started, and I have done that with several people here where I live. Mm-hmm. And there are several people in... So what I'm feeling is that I really believe in it, but I feel like the most chronic cases sort of deserve it first.
Well,
and actually, I'm working on that so that I can finally start just taking it regularly and get all the benefits that everybody else who does not have a chronic condition is experiencing.
Well, I don't know your
so
age.
So that's
but
my answer.
Yeah, that's a good answer. Put you on the spot there, sorry. But this picture
no,
from
that's
the
all right.
You look totally young here. You look like you're in your 30s. Your picture.
I know, and I am 54.
She's faking it. She's giving the dog two and taking the other three.
Well, we won't comment on that.
Thank
I know
you.
That the I've heard that the Nobel Prize winner gives it to her dog, but we won't mention her by name. So we just don't
okay.
know what goes on. Yeah. All right,
no,
Bob,
I really am 54.
Sure.
I mean it.
I know. Well, you look fabulous, darling.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, my dad just turned 80, you know, a week ago, and he's doing great. But, you know, I really do want to start it and see the benefits and grow old with all the people who are taking it. But I did feel I just needed to put the money where it was most necessary first.
Absolutely. I mean, you're a giver. I can't imagine the kind of generosity that you have, but it's wonderful to see.
Oh, thank you.
You want to say a word just about chemotherapy for dogs in general?
Yes. Well, Lulu, apparently dogs can handle the chemo a lot more easily than humans. You know, my very best girlfriend has done 3 months now of carboplatin, and it flattened her every time. But Lulu was actually fine on it, a little bit of nausea, but literally for sort of one episode, and that was it. And then she was fine. I am really recommending it. And the great vet that I went to for the MRSA, for the staph infection, said, Kathy, and this was early on, if you're going to amputate Lulu's leg, you might as well go all the way with the chemo. And what happened is her present vet decided to give her two more rounds because they always stop at four.
Right.
But she spoke to a professor of hers at Colorado State University, which is one of the best, you know, veterinary schools in the country, maybe the best. This dog is so happy. She feels so healthy. Her vets are overwhelmed and astounded. And they've seen everything.
Yeah.
And I live in a community where everybody loves their dogs, and I'm the same way, and I think they would do anything for their dogs.
Yeah.
And I'm just so happy that webinar came my way, and actually Lulu's progress is actually influencing the humans that I am trying to interest in TA-65.
Well, I think fear, especially fear, something that seems so too good to be true, shall we say?
Yes.
It's huge. It's proportionate to the amount of the promise, is the amount of the paranoia. But
that's right.
I think people who have means, maybe they, in a sick way or in a weird way, they could experiment on their dogs first, because I know a lot of people, you know, would do it if they felt it was safe and effective. But that's just a huge, much too huge a leap for most people. Yeah.
Right. And I know Ed, that more and more, the more you, just as a doctor and advocate of TA-65, can delve into that, you know, in the webinars, the better. Because, yes, I think we are at a crossroads of people either deciding they're going to, you know, believe the science or stay with the old myths that have to do with an old protocol that actually doesn't help people live longer. So I think the more you and Dr. Shima and the other doctors do that, the better. I
feel like it's something that's valuable to people because, I mean, let's talk about placebo effect for a minute, bias. I mean, certainly...
Yes.
You want to believe that there's a change, but you know, placebo is a little hard to claim when it's a dog that doesn't speak, you know, standard English, shall we say? So,
right.
Sure, there's observer bias. I mean, something about your good vibes could be healing to her, just like pet therapy. But certainly, the osteosarcoma component of it, which is again 90% metastatic, that's a little harder to evoke the placebo effect or observer bias, I think.
Right. So,